This should work, right?
Now, this big thing right here is a wind generator I bought a while ago from AliExpress. I got interested in it, and still am, because even though I now got solar power on all of my roofs, which produce more than enough power for my home during the day, it does not go so well with power generation during the night. But you know what I got here during the night? Oftentimes quite a bit of wind. And one time even so much that my garden house got partly ripped apart. So even though this wind generator didn't get my thumbs up back when I initially tested it, I still wanted to give it another shot. Mainly because I feel like the culprit could have been the given wind controller, which I actually already got rid of. And also, of course, because this thing was not cheap, and I desperately want some value out of it. So in this video, let's set this thing up properly, do some better investigations, and hopefully find out whether such small wind generators do in fact work, and whether they are worth it. Let's get started!
This video is sponsored by Keysight's upcoming oscilloscope, the HD3. And sadly, right now all I can share are the super close-ups of the oscilloscope, which look intriguing, I would say. But if you want to know more, then sign up for Keysight's H3 launch event using the link below. It comes out on September the 4th, and by signing up, you will be one of the first to see the new HD3 in action. I will see you there. Now let's start off with answering the question whether this thing really is a generator. And in case you're wondering, a generator is basically a component that converts some form of energy into electrical energy. In our case, it is mechanical energy created by the wind. So by soldering an LED between all the three phases of this thing, we can see that all LEDs light up as soon as we turn the rotor, meaning we do in fact create electrical energy, and thus we got a generator on our hand. And did you notice that the three LEDs didn't light up at the same time, but one after the other? The reason can be seen when we hook the three phases up to my oscilloscope. As you can see, we're dealing with a three-phase AC voltage here, which obviously is not yet compatible with a 12-volt DC battery or my 48-volt solar battery system. But don't worry, because we can quickly solder up
a 6-pulse Brückenschaltung,
which looks something like this as a schematic. When hooking it up to the three phases, then we basically create a DC positive and negative pole, meaning we turned the AC voltage into a more suitable DC voltage. But I'm getting ahead of myself here, because we firstly have to properly mount this thing somewhere. For this purpose, the generator came with this metal flange here, that can be mounted to it using nuts and bolts. In the middle, it also comes with a hole, through which we can insert a pipe that we can then somehow secure in the ground. And at first, I was happy to find out that according to the product description, the hole comes with a diameter of 25 mm. Because for that size, I could easily get a fitting pipe in my local home improvement store. But after measuring it myself, it is more like 29 mm, meaning we should not trust this product page, which, by the way, completely changed all of its information since I made my initial video. And finding details about this specific model is also pretty much impossible. Meaning I'm on my own with my investigation here. But anyway, next I of course could get a 29 mm pipe from a specialized store. But I didn't like the idea of pouring some concrete for this thing, only to later find out that it is useless. Luckily for me though, my girlfriend wanted me to set up this rotary clothes dryer for a while now, which gets secured in the earth using such ground sleeves. there exists a plastic and a metal version. And I actually went with the plastic one, because the pipe length can enter the sleeve a bit more with that one. So I determined a suitable spot, started digging, and didn't get tired of it until I got a 30x30cm square with a depth of 40cm. Then I put 10cm of gravel sand in there, compacted that down, and started mixing up the first batch of concrete. After pouring it in, I inserted a plastic pipe into the sleeve, pushed that contraption into the concrete, and positioned it until it was level with all axes. Afterwards, I mixed up more concrete, poured it in there, and was basically done with my job here. After 2 days, everything was hard enough, and the clothes dryer fit wonderfully, as well as probably every pipe with a 50mm diameter, which is exactly the size of metal pipe I got myself next. Now, as you would expect, this thing does not fit through the flange. But luckily for me, I got this welding machine here sitting in my garage for 2 years now, and it should be able to do stick welding. So I positioned the pipe on top of the flange and got to work, which was actually my first time welding, and I feel like the result truly looks like it. But you know what, it seems to hold together nicely, meaning it was time to drill a hole into the pipe, push an extension cable in there, hook that up to the generator wires, finally secure the generator to the pipe, and ultimately position this whole construction in the ground. All that was left now was getting some wind for testing, which I didn't have to wait long for, because just a day later I got speeds of around 3 m/s. And yes, this thing spun beautifully, and as expected didn't have any problems to power my 3 LEDs. Amazing! Well, not really. Because next we need a power converter that basically takes our 3-phase AC voltage and convert it into a suitable DC voltage to, for example, charge up a 12-volt battery. And no, my 6-Puls-Brückenschaltung alone is not the solution here, because it only converts AC to DC, leaving us with a pretty low DC voltage that cannot be used for much. Instead, we need something like a switching converter that can boost or lower the generator's voltage so that it can charge a 12-volt battery. While doing that, it also needs to monitor the flowing current and voltage. Because if we would, for example, draw too much current, which I simulate here by shorting my AC to DC converter outputs, then the wind generator would turn way slower or even stop, and thus produce pretty much no power. So what we want is something in the middle, between max current and no current, which gives us the maximum power, meaning we need a maximum power point tracker, or MPPT. And luckily for me, I found a suitable one online, which does 12 volts and 400 watts. After unpacking it, it looked pretty similar to my old wind controller. So next I hooked it up to my battery and wind generator, and put a current clamp on there to see how much current is flowing. And it seems like this wind speed was not enough, because no current was flowing into the battery. But luckily for me, later the wind picked up, to peaks of up to 6 m/s, which, according to a wind speed chart, is a moderate breeze. And I would say the most common wind speed we got around here. But sadly, once again, pretty much no current was flowing into the battery, even though the rectified voltage of my generator reached peaks of up to 15 volts DC and a short circuit current of 700 milliamps. So to find out what was going on, I hooked up the wind controller to my lab bench power supply, and immediately realized that it does in fact work as an MPPT charger, since it does not overload my power supply here. But the bad news is that it only works best with voltages above 15 volts, which my wind generator will probably never reach for a longer time period at my location. And no, mounting this thing higher up in the air is not possible for me, because that is simply forbidden here. Another solution though that came to my mind was rewinding the coils of the generator, so that it creates a higher output voltage, just like I did in a previous video with a BLDC motor. But before starting such a tedious task, I wanted another reference point, and thus got myself another wind generator, which this time though was a bit cheaper, but still looked pretty promising all put together. And as a bonus, I got my original wind controller back, which states that it works with low wind speeds. And after testing, it seems to also work just fine with higher voltages, and this time even some lower ones, between 8 and 12 volts. But as you can see, in this mode there is no MPPT integrated, meaning with low wind speeds you can at best gather 1.3 watt of wind power, which is pretty much useless. But anyway, it was time to go for a test ride with this new generator, and overall I gotta say that it performed better. I mean, at wind speeds of around 3 meter per second, this thing spun nicely and created a slightly higher voltage than the generator before. And once the wind picked up to around 4 to 5 meter per second, this thing reached peaks of up to 15 volts DC and was even able to charge my battery with peaks of up to 100 milliamps. And I know that this is only around 1.5 watts of power, which is once again pretty useless, but at least it is something. So all in all, these wind generator tests were disappointing for me, because I kind of hoped that such speeds would create some useful power. But as it turns out, these generators are definitely made for higher speeds, which makes me wonder whether I should next try modifying them or even come up with my own low wind speed power converter. And to end this video, I can now pretty confidently say that in around 95% of the cases, using a wind generator is not worth it, because of its cost, time to set up, and required wind speed to get any decent output power. And with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!